Hello, everybody. This is Scott Bradley coming to you from www.scottbradley.name. And in this Evernote Scott video today, it's going to be a very quick video, and I'm going to cover exactly how I set up my swipe file in my Evernote account. If you don't know what a swipe file is, what it is in simple terms is a space where you can go and reference if you're creating marketing and you want to use your swipe file as inspiration. Let's say, for instance, you're creating a banner campaign and you wanted to look at other banner campaigns from other past people, either in your niche or outside of your niche. It's really, really valuable to have a swipe file to go back to for inspiration for what you want to create. So in using Evernote, I've created a way and a structure that's going to work for you if you're a marketer, if you're a business owner, if you manage a lot of the marketing for your company, if you work for a normal corporation. This is going to be really valuable for you. So let's get started. What you want to do is you want to create a swipe file notebook stack. So as you can see here, the title of my stack is called swipe file. And then what I have done is put the different media types as the sub notebooks. So just for illustration purposes, I have banners, book covers, Facebook ads, promoted tweets, and websites. Now, the only reason why I limited this list mainly is because I know depending on your business, you're going to want to swipe different types of media. So you could put videos here, you could put YouTube videos here, you could put sales pages, you could put capture pages, but it is really important that you have the title of the notebook stack as swipe file, and then every notebook under it as the media type. And you're gonna see why that's really important here in a second, but I wanna make sure that you have the structure first. So as you start creating this, think about, okay, what am I copying, what am I saving? And then what kind of media type or media bucket does it fall under? And then create those notebooks for you. So after you have done that, the next step is to then start filling your swipe file. Now, if you're anything like me, you probably have multiple screenshots every which way on your computer in multiple folders. That's a big mess and there's no sense of organization. And when you go and actually jump into your swipe file, you probably just get so overwhelmed that it is just a big, frustrating mess when you have to either write an email, you need to write a sales page, you need to write a capture page, you need to create a postcard, you need to write a letter. It's not an organized, symbiotic way of going back to your swipe file to know what you need to create. So I have solved that problem using Evernote and have created a structure that works best for you. So I'm going to start with the banners, and then I'm going to show you how tags are going to able to make it so easy to organize and reference later as you go back to it. So what you want, the structure that you want to follow is obviously notebook stack is swipe file. The notebook that you select is the media type, and then each note within the media type. So let's just say for banners, what you want to do is in the title of the note, you want to put the name of the person of whose ad it is and the company name as well. Now, as you can see here, there's two types of notes that are going to fall into the banners category. More likely, if it's a big corporation like a Staples, which I'm going to show you here in a second, you would only put the company name. But let's say, for instance, you're in the real estate niche and you're the real estate realtor niche, and you're following other agents and your competitors, and you want to kind of spy on their online banners that they're using, you would ideally put, you know, name of person, let's just say, you know, Ryan Smith, and then the company name would be Cordwell Banker or Remax or whatever, and or whatever real estate company that is who you are representing. So in each of these notes, you're going to want to put your screenshot of your picture of your banner here. And then what I typically do is I put in like a couple notes of what I liked best about it. So I like the color, I like the layout, I like how they promoted it on xyz.com website on the top right or the bottom or the top leaderboard banner, whatever it is. Now, after you have done that, here's where the magic happens from a management and going back to it standpoint. So let's just visualize that we're going to have thousands of different notes from company persons and people and different banners and different creatives. And let's just say you have thousands of notes. Obviously, if you were to go back to this banners notebook, you would be like, oh my gosh, what the heck? How do I find the one from Ryan and his company this and this? I want to just see those banners within his scope. Well, that's where the power of tagging comes in. So the way you want to structure your tags in simple terms is the very first thing you want to do is going down here. You're going to see the kind of the list of tags that I started to build. Is you want to first create a tag titled Swipe A File. Now, the reason why I have A, B, and C here is just for organizational purposes because of the way that the Evernote web-based version structures and alphabetizes this. But I know that on the desktop, you can structure it any way that you want and move things up and down. But again, just for illustration purposes, to make it clear in your mind, I'm just showing you the step-by-step here in the structure that's going to keep it so easy to understand. So the very first thing that you want to do is first have a tag, no matter what, called Swipe A File. Now, if you remember in past videos, I used another prefix called Peeps. And this was for like my people pad and my people conversations. So again, if you can imagine, you're going to have hundreds of tags here and you're going to know exactly which ones are my swipe file tags, which one are my contact tags, which one are my people tags. So that's why I have the first swipe in capital S-W-I-P-E and then file. So you want to make sure you have that one first. Then the next one that you want to, the next kind of modality of tags that you want to be creating are the media types. So you have swipe, and I have B, banner. Swipe, B, book cover. Swipe, B, Facebook ads. Swipe, B, promoted tweets. And then finally, the third modality of tagging, and you're going to see why this is valuable in a second, so just stick with me here, is swipe, C, person's name. So right here I have John Smith. Or swipe, C, company name. So A, B, C. It's simple as A, B, C. Yes, that was supposed to be funny. Ha ha. Anyway, so you have your swipe file. That's going to be the tag that you always create. And then depending on what media types, those are going to be your B swipe file tags. And then your C swipe file tags are going to be the person's name and or company name. So here's how we're going to tag this. So let's just say that I had a picture of a banner here that I took from, you know, surfing on the web. And I'm going to go up here to the top here and go, you know, add a tag here. And I can just go S-W-I-P-E. And they all fall down there, which is just beautiful. You click swipe a file, which I've already done here. And I'm going to try, I'll just pop this here. And so swipe a file. And then I'm going to also do swipe B banner because we're in, again, we are in the banners notebook. And then swipe C Ryan Smith. Now, I did not know what Ryan Smith's company name was, so I just looked at the ad. And again, you got to work with this the way you want to work with it. That's going to work best for your brain. But at the end of the day, you know, I just did A file, B banner, C person name. Now, for the company name ones, you're going to do swipe A file, swipe B banner, swipe C company name, which is C Staples. I just kind of use that as an example. So swipe C Staples. Now, as you can imagine, the reason this is really valuable and the reason why these tags are so important with how you're micromanaging it this way is, let's say that I went to you and I said, I want to see all of your banners that Staples has run that you've saved in your swipe file. Let me show you how to do that. What you're going to do is you're going to go click the banners notebook. You're going to come down here and you're going to click and you're going to go up here and go swipe a file. And then you're going to come up here and go swipe B banners. And you're going to swipe One second. As you know, this is not always perfect. Swipe a file, swipe the banner, swipe C Staples. Boom. Search. Then only banners in your swipe file from Staples are going to all show up here. And then it gives you the ability to go click, 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 click. Oh, I have my inspiration. I can go and create my banner now. And so that is the reason why these tags are so important, is because it allows you to filter anything that you want to get to quickly and efficiently. So again, let's just say that you wanted to look at your entire swipe file of only banners. Okay, so what you would do is you would click swipe file at the top, and you'd click swipe B banner, search. So it only pulls up all of the banners in your swipe file. Now let's just see, you were gonna do only company names or person. And now you'd say that you would wanna, you know that one company has banners, they do emails, they do websites. Let's say you wanted to be company specific. Again, you'd wanna click the stack total up here and you go swipe. Let's just see company specific. So swipe C Staples, search. So you would only see, you would see the banners of Staples in here. You would see the Facebook ads of Staples in here. You would see the emails that Staples sends. All of their marketing, company specific, would all be in this note. I hope you're excited right now, because when I figured this out and cracked the code on this, it was a totally freeing experience, because I finally knew that I could create a swipe file that was A, easy to access, B, easy to organize, C, easy to populate, and D, easy to find whatever I wanted when I wanted to create future campaigns, either because, you know, typically I am in the marketing consulting business growth space, and so my swipe file is massive, full of different copy swipes, banner swipes, email swipes, capture page swipes, sales page swipes, video swipes, the whole thing. And with this setup, it easily allows me to go back to my swipe file and easily find what I'm looking for depending on what I need to create. So I really hope that this was massively valuable for you. If you haven't already done so, I highly recommend that you sign up for updates. Go to scottbradley.name/evernotetips. And here you're going to find a form to sign up. And every time that I have a new video posted to the channel, I will be sending you an email letting you know. And that's pretty much the main purpose of this email list that you're signing up for. Every new video, you get an email. So you get it on time, immediate, and we don't have to rely on YouTube, which isn't always the most reliable. So I hope you enjoyed this video. As you can see here, I also created book covers, Facebook ads, promoted tweets, websites. And so it really allows you to, I'm just looking at the book covers here. You have the image of the book, what you liked. Again, tagging swipe A file, swipe B book cover, swipe C Sally Sue, because we knew the author's name. Again, very simple, easy, straightforward. I hope this was valuable for you. If you haven't already done so, please do subscribe to the channel, sign up for email updates, and I really do appreciate your thumbs up and your likes and sharing these with your network. Have a great rest of your day, a wonderful rest of the week, and I look forward to making the next video for you. Have a good one. Bye-bye.